I've been speaking to Dane, you know, and Dane is from my hometown and I know him very well, and I asked a bit of advice from him, and you know, and also met the chairman. I had a one-on-one with him and he explained to me the dynamics of the club and the history the club has, and I just feel that I need to make the next step in my career. Yeah, you know, it's been a tough decision for me to make, you know, it's a life-changing decision for me, you know, so it wasn't easy to make the decision, you know. But as you know, I've been for the club for so long and I've been through the academy ranks and I've been at the first team. A new coach came in. I've been able to get to know him well, and he's been really well receiving towards me, and I've been training well under him, and I've been enjoying my time since he came. So for me, it was a tough decision in that regard, you know. But in joining Pirates, you know, the name already says enough. You know, it has a lot of history, and joining Pirates for me it's an honour, and I'm happy that I'm looked at as one of the talented players in the country to be joining them. It wasn't anything specific, you know. It was whether I needed a change or a new challenge or a change of environment, and I felt that I needed that, and that's why I made the decision to move. For me, it all boiled down to who really wanted me, and Pirates just showed the most interest, and you know, whether it doesn't matter who it was, if whoever showed the most interest, I would have gone to, and I feel that I can blossom and my career can finally take off now that I've joined Pirates.
Are you disappointed that you have not linked up with your former coach, Pizzo?
No, not at all. You know, Sundowns is a big club. You know, they've been signing a lot of players, and I think they have enough players in the respective areas they need. And I think that, you know, going to Pirates would be the right, and for me, joining Pirates was the right move and the right decision that I've made. No, I haven't spoken to Roger at all, but, you know, I've read about the interviews he's been speaking about me, and, you know, I'm quite happy that he's excited about having me, and, you know, if a team that said that, so I'm really excited to work with him and looking forward to meeting my new teammates. Yeah, that it's a life-changing decision and that my life won't be the same ever again, and they'll be happy to have me as a player, and because I'm really talented and I should just give my best and work hard. And well, everybody has the right to their opinion, you know, so I don't really get into that, you know. And in life, in general, people always criticize you, whether you do good or bad, you know. So for me, it's not really my concern. I think that, you know, yeah, they might have a point, and if you look at my statistics, it doesn't speak volumes, but that's all in the past. And the coach always told me, you know, you're only as good as your last game. So whether you haven't scored in 3 years or not, if you've played your last game scoring 3 goals, people will forget about what you haven't done in the past and remember what you've done the last game. So that's what I live by. He has his own way of playing, and unfortunately didn't suit me, you know, so that was the only difficulty I had, not with him, but with the way of football. Yeah, he knew that, you know, that's why he put me on the left, because I'm not the type of player that would fight in the air, and, you know, the long balls is not my style of playing, you know. At times it worked for the club, you know, and at times it didn't, and unfortunately, you know, it wasn't the way I enjoy playing my game. Last season. I came to him a couple of times last season, you know. I can't choose out when those times were, but, you know, for me it was just about, you know, getting a new environment, you know. I just wasn't happy with not playing regularly in the position I prefer to play in, so that was basically my decision on wanting to get a move. So he's been a great coach, you know. I mean, if you look at his statistics, it speaks volumes, you know, 3 league titles, back to back, you know, so he's a great coach. I know I've learned a lot. He was actually the first coach to give me my debut in the PSL, and I'll forever be grateful for that. Yeah, I'm aware of that, you know. Unfortunately, you know, that's how football is, but, you know, I didn't join Pirates just to play in the CAF. I joined Pirates because of the history they have and the way the club is, the how big the club is and the history it has, and I just want to be part of that, and hopefully I can add some value to the club. For me, it's not to respond in the media about what whoever says about me, and I just handle it in a respectful manner. And I contacted Stan and I told him about the article that was wrote, that was said about me by the chairman, you know. And I felt that, you know, from a personal point of view, it wasn't the right way to go, you know. And I have a huge amount of respect for the chairman, but to criticize a player of his own in that manner, I just didn't agree with that, so I didn't go out to the media and criticize him back, you know. I just handled it in a professional manner. I called Stan and we handled it internally. Yeah, you know, that's his take on me, you know. If he feels that I'm a prima donna, then I'm happy that he thinks that, you know. It's not really for me to criticize back, and, you know, that's not the way to go, you know. That's just not how I handle my business, so I just feel that, you know, it was a bit of disrespectful towards me and towards my family, but what can I do, you know. It's going and retaliating is not the way to go. No, I haven't spoken to him, but I've spoken to Stan. He has apologized on the chairman's behalf, and I accepted his apology, and life goes on.
As much as we are sad, you know, to lose a player of the caliber of Kermit. We really are. It wasn't our first choice. Our first choice would have been for him to stay on and extend his contract with us. But once he, as is his right, decided that he would not extend his contract with us any further, as a club, we felt that it was time to part ways and to bring the future in now so that Kermit can get on with his life where he wants to play and we can get on with our job of, you know, replacing him and hopefully challenging for honours and, you know, being successful as a team. I want to take this opportunity to congratulate Kermit, you know, on his move, to wish him well, because wherever he goes, whether it's Orlando Pirates or beyond, he will always be a super sport player. He will always be a legacy for us as to our youth development program and what we can produce. And he will always be a source of pride for the club and for me personally. For the, I don't think that it was purely a financial situation at all. Kermit's been with us since he's 12 and he's only ever known super sport. That's been his whole life. Besides his 2 years with Feyenoord, and bear in mind, before Kermit went to Feyenoord, he was there 16 times on training excursions and training opportunities. From the age of 13 to the age that he was signed at 18, he went 16 times to Holland, sometimes for up to 3 months. So, but it was always under our wing. And from a football perspective, I think he wants to test himself in other markets. It wasn't purely finance. So it wasn't a one-sided situation where we could just throw more money and that would have made all the other issues go away. There were other issues that weren't financial at all. There was obviously financial elements that were being driven from, let's say, the management side of Kermit. I don't want to get into that. For me, our primary relationship is with Kermit, and we factored in his feelings and his thoughts about what he wanted as a footballer and as a person. The financial considerations were a separate consideration. It wasn't merely a case of us having to try and match or better any other offer. And as a club, we also didn't feel that we needed to be pushed into that situation where it's as if, we Johnny Come Lately club vying for his services. We've looked after Kermit well for a long, long time. From our point of view, it was more engaging Kermit about what he wanted for his football career and as a person, and then his management side dealt with the financial element.